Okay, dear colleagues, we proceed to the next session of the conference. And the first speaker of the session is Maxim Evgenievich Frolov with the title Error Control for Problem in Coserat Elasticity Theory. Please.
Thank you very much.
Александр, меня слушать надо переключать, нет?
Это вообще не надо.
Не надо? Типа. Dear colleagues, good day. First of all, I want to thank organizing committee for this invitation to this conference. For me, it's very important event. Of course, I knew Olga Alexandrovna much less than many of you. I met her only several times when I was young PhD student, but for me it was also very important, and I was really impressed. After such meetings, usually people fall in love with mathematics for many years. My presentation will be about a posteriori error estimation for special mechanical problems with some microstructures. Problems are called, the corresponding theories are called micropolar, or the particular case is Coserat elasticity theory. So it's simple, one of the simplest modifications of classical elasticity theory. During the last 15 years, this is joint work with Professor Sergei Igorevich Repin, with Professor Pekka Neitan-Mäki, and also my former PhD students, Dr. Maria Churilova and Dr. Olga Chistikova. And we worked with problems in 2D and 3D with classical elasticity, Coserat elasticity, and also Reisner-Midland plates. Research was developed in Stiklov Institute, St. Petersburg Department of Stiklov Institute, also University of Jyväskylä, with Pekka Neitan-Mäki, and Petrus Great St. Petersburg Polytechnic University. And now I focus on problems of Coserat elasticity, but I need to start with classical elasticity and with some short introduction. If we denote as U the exact solution of our problem, and if we compute some approximate solution with mesh parameter H, we can divide two classes of error estimates. First class is called a priori error estimates, where some norm of difference between exact solution and approximate solution is estimated by some unknown, generally unknown constant, which depends on the exact solution and mesh parameter in some power of alpha. This estimate usually is not explicitly computable. For this case, we need some explicitly computable error estimate, which is called a posteriori error estimate. This estimate depends explicitly on approximate solution and given data of the problem. So we can compute it with approximate solution, which we have computed from some code, maybe even commercial code. And the well-known characteristic is the so-called efficiency or effectivity index. This is simply ratio between error estimate and exact value of the error. Of course, the optimal value of efficiency index is one, and if this efficiency index is less than one, that it means that method is not reliable. And if we guarantee that efficiency index is all or equal to one, it means that our method is reliable. And estimates are always reliable. But of course, this method should be reasonably efficient. So this index, in the case where this index is about 10, this estimate is not efficient because engineer believes that error is about 100%, but really it's only 10%. So we overestimate error too much. So efficiency index should be between 1 and maybe 2 or 3. It's good. And we use functional approach. Here I provide some references on this approach. And you can find this monographs where you can read some about this approach in detail. Key features of the functional approach for control are the first one is that this approach is able to control any conforming approximation as approximate solution. And it's not necessary that this approximation possess Galerkin orthogonality properties. So we can control every approximation from functional class. The second one, for this reason, it's reliable and robust to some deviations, even maybe some bugs of computer code. So if your computer code computes a solution with some bugs and you have actually not Galerkin approximation, you will see it when you try to control the error. And for example, for ANSYS, this well-known complex for computer-aided engineering, for some problems due to some locking effects and so on, we never compute Galerkin approximation by this code. This approximation usually does not possess Galerkin orthogonality property, especially for plates, for Reisner-Midland plates. So we can use a functional approach together with black box software where we can have many details hidden in some manuals or maybe even hidden and details do not describe everywhere. So you can, this is some commercial secret and you never find details of computation. And now I want to start from classical linear elasticity. It's well known. Let me have domain omega in R2, so it's plane domain with bounded connected with Lipschitz continuous boundary. And we have classical equations, equilibrium equation, Hooke's law, and also linear relation between strain tensor and displacement. So we have unknown displacements and we can compute stresses and strains. And we have two non-intersecting parts of the boundary gamma. Here we have Dirichlet type boundary condition. Here we have Neumann type boundary condition. So we have boundary attractions given on this part of the boundary. And of course, we consider generalized formulation of this problem. We integrate by parts and we use standard Sobolev spaces for our solution. And now the key feature of functional approach that we need to introduce new variables And we consider arbitrary approximate solution U tilde from our functional space. And after some manipulations, we can get error estimate, where error is estimated by two terms. And this estimate involves some constant, but this constant is general, is mesh independent. So we don't need to recompute this constant during a mesh refinement process. And this term is simply some counterpart of this error if we take square root of this. And this term is some weighted representation of squares of residuals. So if we substitute instead of sigma with two tildes, we substitute exact stress tensor, we get that error is equal to zero. And D is equal to the error. So we can provide efficiency index, which is as close to one as we need. This is only question of computational effort. So estimate, simple estimate looks like this. When we have Cauchy inequality with parameter, such type of estimates is well investigated, but for implementation is better to modify this estimate. You can find modified estimate in this book of Sergey Igorevich. And the key feature of the new estimate is that it's not necessary for stress tensor for this sigma with two tildes to be symmetric tensor. It's important because from viewpoint of approximation, this approximation which is symmetric is not so easy to construct. And it's important that for such type of estimates, it's very suitable to use classical Ravyar-Tama approximation. For this case, this approximation includes degrees of freedom not in knots of our finite element, but in the middles of edges. And there is another approximation, which is even more suitable than Ravyar-Tama, and it's newer than Ravyar-Tama. It's Arnold-Baffi-Falk approximation. Here we have additional degrees of freedom related to divergence. And if we go back to this representation, actually, here we have divergence. And for this reason, additional degree of freedom, 2 degrees of freedom related to divergence are more suitable than a finite element without such degrees of freedom. And now I go to Cassera elasticity. This theory was proposed more than 100 years ago, but then it was mentioned as some stupid idea more than for 50 years. And only in the beginning of 60s, Eringen, Midlin, Nowatzki, Truesdell, Airo, and some other great specialists, like in our country, it was Airo and Vladimir Alexandrovich Palmov, well-known specialist in mechanics, looked at this theory and understood that this theory is very important generalization of classical theory. What it gives? This theory, additional degree of freedom is introduced. This degree of freedom has a sense of independent rotation of particle of microstructure like solid body. So we have some included influence of this microstructure to our media. And now we have three variables, displacements and rotation. And we can also include to our considerations some distributed moments. And we have additional tensor, which is called coupled stress tensor, in addition to stress tensor itself. And what is important, that stresses have no symmetry from this point of view. And for this reason, approximations like Arnold-Boffy-Falk approximation are very important and can be implemented here directly. And from viewpoint of error estimation, I found only a few articles. All of them are mentioned here, where some classical approaches was applied, were applied to a posteriori error estimation. And we started with Sergey Grigorievich's work about implementation of functional approach to error control for Cassera elasticity. The difference between Cassera and classical elasticity is as the following. We have additional term, including this relation between derivatives of displacement and micro rotation. And we have two additional constants. In the simplest case, we have two additional constants. Constants which are related with microstructure. And here you can find standard assumptions. And if we again consider any conformant approximation from our functional space and we consider error, now this error is triple of components, error in displacements and error in rotation. We can provide for this square of energy error, we can provide for computational for numerical experiments, we can provide lower estimate using reference solution. So we can substitute here some solution on very fine mesh, and then we can compute lower estimate for error. And for upper estimate, we need to introduce again some additional components. They are split into vectors because we want to use Arnold-Boffy-Falk approximation in this case. So we split tensor into two components, two vectors. Now it's possible because we have no symmetry, so we have no direct relation between this component and this component. We can split it. And these characteristics are computable explicitly. They are equipped with tilde. And we need to compute this vector fields with two tildes. And of course, exact values of stresses and exact values of coupled stresses will provide accurate error estimate. And estimate actually has the same form as for classical elasticity, but a little bit more complicated structure. And again, this estimate is exact if we set if we put here exact values of stresses and so on, we will have that this term vanishes, and we can set beta is equal to zero, and then term D will represent our error exactly. So we need estimate with constant C, which is also the same constant, not exactly, but with the same meaning we can find in classical elasticity. Again, we have such constant here. And now, very short example, numerical example to better understanding what we do such. So if we try to refine our mesh without any error estimation, and we simply do uniform refinement, we get a solution with error which is less of 2% with 70 thousandths of knots. But if we use for classical elasticity, we use measurement based indicator, we get the same accuracy with very reasonable overestimation of the true error. We get with only 3 thousandths of knots. So we have tens times of tens times less computational efforts for computation of our solution. And for Cassera elasticity situation is the same. We have 10 times less amount of knots to get accuracy, which is more than 98%. And also very, very reasonable overestimation of the true error. This efficiency index is close to one. And if we compare usage of reference indicator, if we compute, which is very hard to compute efficiently, we compute reference solution on very fine mesh, and if we compute measurement-based indicator, we get almost the same results. So it's very good. For 3D situation is more or less the same, but of course structure is much more complicated. Now we have vector of displacements with three displacement components and also three rotation components. So we have a fully described motion of particle inside of our continuum, but structure is the same. We have this term with which is counterpart of the true error, and we have this term which is some weighted representation of squares of residuals, and we have now couple stress tensor here, which is related to curvature. And again, structure is quite complicated, but if we substitute exact values of couple stresses and stresses, we immediately get that R2 will vanish, and term D will represent our exact error. So this is only a question of computational effort, how to get an efficient error estimate. But this estimate is not implemented yet. So it's for me personally, it's important future question to implement this estimate and prove computational efficiency of this estimate. I think it's necessary to find some, first of all, it's necessary to find some analog of Arnold-Bafi-Falk element, because Arnold-Bafi-Falk element is actually a plane element, but we need the same in 3D, because I think that Ravyav-Tamayan 3D will not so efficient as some generalization of Arnold-Bafi-Falk. So this is important for further investigation. And again, in our estimate, we have no mesh dependent constants. So we have only some general constant, which is mesh independent. We compute it once, and then we don't need to recompute it when we refine our mesh. So conclusions, we consider the functional approach which is always reliable. So we have estimates which are guaranteed. We prove that for Cassera elasticity, it's efficient at least in 2D. And we have some moderate overestimation of the error. And what we have also, the functional approach is suitable even when we use coarse meshing, and we can use it actually for commercial software. So we can use this approach for control of errors in commercial software as like a black box. So thank you for attention.
Thank you. Questions, please. Well, I have a question. Slide 17, please. Yeah. So, lower estimates. Actually, it is important. And your suggestion is to use reference solution on a very fine grid. But is it possible to avoid solution on a very fine grid to give a lower estimate?
Yes, of course, you can find works of Professor Ripon for other problems. Here we use reference solution because it's simplest way. Because our meshes are not so fine and we can...
And it is 2D.
Yes, and we can spend some time to compute very fine solution and to have two-sided estimate for purely for numerical experiments, but of course for real life problems, it's more important to have some lower estimate, which is computed can be computed more efficiently. For this case, you can find some results in book of professor.
Okay, thank you. Other questions? Well, if no other questions, thank you very much once again.
Thank you.